disease. Now, the declining bee population has long been a cause for concern. In the last 70 years, two species have become extinct in the UK. But now we can all help try to halt the decline with a new app that you can download on your smartphone. And find out more now from Shefali, who's out in the sunshine at Wrighton Organic Gardens near Coventry. Shefali.
Thank you very much, Nick. Yes, this new app has been developed by Coventry University, and it's part of a project that everybody can get involved in. What they'd like you to do is take photographs of bumblebees in your gardens and simply upload them. And from that, they'll get information on what kinds of plants the bumblebees thrive on. Well, our reporter Kevin Reed has been finding out more.
This is the new Blooms for Bees app that scientists would like gardeners and anybody else who's interested to help with their research. Those who download it can take pictures of bumblebees in their back gardens, allotments, or even public parks. Then they simply submit them.
The photographs and all other information from the apps will be analysed by scientists at Coventry University, who will then be able to work out exactly what kind of plants bumblebees prefer.
They'll even be able to narrow it down to the particular preferences of the 25 species of bumblebees in the UK.
There's certain plants which I found as particular favourites. Things like marjoram, when it's flowering, it's absolutely plastered in bumblebees. Things like chives, they really seem to like as well. And borage, they really like. So there are certainly things which they really seem to like.
Bumblebees originate from the Himalayas 35 million years ago. There are 250 species worldwide, playing an important role.
They're actually slightly electrostatically charged, so they pick up pollen very easily. And they pollinate plants more effectively than certain other species like honeybees. So they're responsible for a lot of our food production, pollinating flowering plants in our gardens so that they can produce seed. And they're part of a wider ecosystem as well that humans are part of. So they're really important. They're part of our world.
Those interested in getting involved should search for the Blooms for Bees app. Kevin Reed, BBC Midlands Today, Warwickshire.
Yeah, bumblebees are indeed critical to our ecosystem, if you've just heard over there. But also, did you know that bumblebees pollinate around a third of everything we eat? Perhaps things like these, which are called cucumelons. Now, they're fruits, but they're cucumbers. Well, they taste like cucumbers with a slightly sour taste. And that's what's amazing about this place, Wrighton Organic Gardens. They have a whole variety of different and unusual plants and vegetables. In fact, I learned something new today. They have such things as seed guardians, who are people who safeguard heritage varieties of plants and vegetables, such as purple peas and beans. It really is a very nice place indeed. But all of these plants and vegetables, of course, need water, and we've got plenty of that heading our way over the next 36 hours. Now, this is how the rest of the week is shaping up.